All right. First and foremost, I want to start off by saying, Barakatha Yahweh, Barakatha Yahweh Shai, Barakatha Yahweh, Barakatha Yahweh Shai, Barakatha Yahweh, Barakatha Yahweh Shai, Kol Halal Yahweh Ba'ashem Yahweh Shai, Ba'ashem Raka Kwadash. Double honors to the apostles of GMS, Great Millstone, who rule well and who taught me this truth. And Shalom to you, sincere Akiyam, out there listening, learning, and pushing this truth. And Shalom to the few sincere Akwath that are out there listening and learning as well. With that being said, I'm going to jump straight into this video. I don't want to rot this out. This will be edifying. As usual, I'm going to go into Raka Kwadash. And it's going to be a super, super quick one. This video popped up in my news feed. And of course, Second Ezra popped into my mind. All right. Coming to a city near you, especially in Babylon the Great. You better believe it. Sooner than later. So this is off of Reuters. And it reads, read the description also. Haitian gangs call for armed overthrow of Prime Minister Henry as chaos escalates. Haitian gangs call for armed overthrow of PM Prime Minister Henry as chaos escalates. Again, coming to a city near you. For sure, it's coming to Babylon the Great. You better believe, bet your life on it. All right? And it's going to happen sooner than later. So this reads, Haiti's most powerful gang leader calls for the armed overthrow of Prime Minister Ariel Henry, urging people to take to the streets in the latest escalation of a country's ongoing humanitarian crisis. And as the cost of living goes up, inflation sets in, mass layoffs take place, there's famine in the street, you know, there's you go to the grocery stores, the shelves are empty. You know, these people are going to lash out, you know, and it's all, we know, it's biblical prophecy. You know, these are the times that we're living in, because the people, not just here in Babylon the Great, but in the whole world, globally, they're tired of being oppressed, all right? They're tired of these wicked-ass leaders. A lot of these leaders are nothing more than puppets for the wicked elite, okay? And so the people are going to call for what? Sedition. Matter of fact, let's get the definition of sedition. Sedition means a conduct or speech inciting people to rebel against the authority of a state or monarch. All right? And this is going to be a global thing. And it's really orchestrated by the wicked elite, just like in Haiti. You know, we know that Esau Edom, he's the one that's given these different gangs a lot of their weapons, and they're really doing the bidding of the elite, okay? Because they have an agenda to destroy the current economy, the current society that you see, order out of chaos, the Hegelian dialect. So again, we know this is prophecy. Again, this is the scripture that was screaming in my mind. We know it, but you know, it needs to come out, because these are the times that we're living in. So I'll start at 15. Second Ezra 15, the main point is in 16, but I'll start at 15. For the sword, right? And we know the modern day sword is what? The gun. And you see that's what he's carrying. A sword is a killing instrument. The modern day sword is the gun, okay? And the ultimate sword is going to be a missile. The Lord's sword, the Lord's arrows, the ICBMs, that's the ultimate judgment. But Yehoshua HaMashiach said he comes to set fire on the earth, and what may he if it be already kindled? When our Lord returns, Yehoshua HaMashiach, when he returns in the midst of the third's woe, in the midst of Jacob's trouble, all hell is already going to be breaking loose, all right? Daniel 12:1, a time like never before, evil times, martial law, pestilence, race wars, civil unrest, you know, class wars, that's what's coming. For the sword and their destruction draweth nigh. It's near. It's near. And one people shall stand up and fight against another, and swords in their hands. The modern day sword again is the gun. For there shall be sedition among men, and invading one another. They shall not regard their kings nor princes, and the course of their actions shall stand in their power. A man shall desire to go into a city and shall not be able. That's why martial law is going to kick in. They're going to lock these cities down. They're going to put checkpoints. You know, there's going to be troops, you know, military troops on, you know, National Guard deployed, you know, curfews. That's the times that we're coming into. You know, loot, they do it. Any little disaster, you see, that's what the first thing they do is they go and loot the stores. So how much more so when society collapses, you know, it's going to be the purge out there. It says, a man shall desire to go into a city and shall not be able, for because of their pride. And it's going to catch a lot of you off guard, because we keep warning you. We're broken records. Prophecies are screaming. We're the watchmen. We keep filtering everything through the scriptures. We keep showing you, telling you over and over, blowing that trumpet. But a lot of you aren't taking heed. So that day is going to catch you as a thief in the night, because you're in the spirit of peace and safety. And we know the scriptures say, when they shall say peace and safety, what? Sudden destruction shall come upon them as a woman in travail, and none shall escape. Okay? This thing is going to catch a lot of you off guard, because you don't think it'll ever happen in America, but you're sadly mistaken. You're in for a rude awakening. It says, a man shall desire to go into a city and shall not be able, for because of their pride. Again, that's what? 2 Ezra 8:50, I believe. For many great miseries shall happen to them that dwell in the world in the latter times, roughly paraphrasing, because they have walked on in great pride. For because of their pride, the city shall be troubled. Pride goeth before destruction. The houses shall be destroyed. They're going to be going door to door. You know, just these the troops are going to be going door to door, you know, the Gurkha troops, UN troops, they're going to be going door to door also, but like, what they call them, militias, these little militia groups, you know, they're going to be ganging up like in the purge, kicking in doors, ravishing women, you know, taking resources, looting, pillaging, you know. For because of their pride, the city shall be troubled. The houses shall be destroyed, and men shall be afraid. And if men are going to be afraid in that day, how much more so you women? That's why a man is going to be like a covert from the wind in those times. You know, the winds of destruction. And not just any man, an Israelite man, is going to be a hedge of protection. It says, a man shall have no pity upon his neighbor. Because Yahushua HaMashiach already told you that the love of many is going to wax cold. Amen. And it's waxing cold as we speak. People are becoming heartless, you know. A man shall have no pity upon his neighbor, but shall destroy their houses with the sword. Again, the modern day sword is the gun. And spoil their goods because of the lack of bread and for great tribulation, for lack of food, a lack of jobs, you know. Ends meeting, you know, that's what's going to happen, you know, and it's going to cause, again, what? Sedition. It's going to cause the people to lash out, okay? So what you see going on in Haiti is coming to a city near you, okay? Whether you believe it or not, whether you accept it or not, and whether you understand it or not, and it's going to happen sooner than later, all right? So anyway, with that being said, I don't want to rot this was edifying. As usual, we're close, man. Keep pushing. Keep fighting. Shalom. Wa abad babo. Kwam yasharallah.